Mr. President, this is a blog. It is a cowardly blog. This is something we cannot avoid these days. Maraming blog, hindi naglalagay ng pangalan. Maraming sumasagot sa Facebook o sa mga Twitter na hindi nagbibigay ng tunay na pangalan. So sa akin, I would give it short shrift, Mr. President. However, if I may call on some order, Mr. President, because I think it's important. It is important to me, Mr. President, because it strikes at the very heart of the Senate. As far as I'm concerned, this is an act of perfidiousness. It lacks candor. It is cowardly. Some people decide to file a resolution. We are not informed. They pass it around. For my part, I was told, magpadala ng email, hindi doon sa main email ko, pero, I mean, I would have reacted, but, Mr. President, napakahirap naman ata ng ganyan na biglang ipa-file. Isang araw, nagagalit si Senate President, si my good friend Senator Dilon, na hindi dumaan sa kanya yung minority report, yung impirma ng minority. And I said, I apologize. Eh, inikot yun eh, pero hindi inabot. In fact, hindi ko nung nga sinabi that mag-uusap kami na na-cancel pa ni Senator Dilon yung usapan namin tungkol doon sa barangay election eh. Because, we're friends. I understand. Magbibigay naman ako eh. Hindi naman ako mahirap kausapin eh. Pero in this particular instance, ito pong resolution na ito galing sa mga kasama natin. Hindi ko alam kung sino. Napaka-simple lang, tawagan ka o puntahan ka as we do. Kung napaka-importante yan. Pero para i-file ka agad isang resolution and then ipalalabas sa blog o sa media, at sisiraan, di bali ko ako lang eh. Eto na naman. Pati yung organization ko na minamahal namin, ang aking ina, ang aking pamilya, ang maraming tao, 2 million volunteers, eh sisiraan pa. Eh teka muna. Iba, usapan na yan. Mr. President, I think amongst the senators here, bihira naman yung namatayan eh. Napinatay ang pamilya eh. And my record will state that even before, in my first Senate, I've always stood up here. Because my father was assassinated, because a niece was killed, I would stand up. A niece that is 9 years old. Bakit ako hindi aangal dyan? You saw me the other night, dun sa issue ng hazing. You saw that even if I was a frat man and so are others here, I said that is unforgivable. It is a frat man, it is a frat that walang prinsipyo, na tinuturoan magsinungaling. And that is exactly what this is. Kasinungalingan eh. The perpetration of a resolution without giving ourselves a chance to look at it and sign it, that is a lie. To publish it is a lie. My gosh, I mean, I'm working on a resolution of our organization that is going to be signed in ASEAN upstairs with some international Red Cross personalities. And Senator Sabiris went there and I said, I cannot be disturbed right now because I'm trying to rush this. And I was told by one of them, what is this lie that they're perpetrating na hindi ka pumirma doon sa resolution na against killing of young people? Mr. President, I have brought many children to PGH, conjoined twins, people with twisted bodies coming out of disasters, brought them to hospitals. I don't have to justify myself. I don't even want to define myself as a humanitarian. I just do it because that is the way I was taught. In times of crisis, Your Honor, in floods, I stop from an amphibian and go down and I ask, may laman ba yung ambulansya yan? Sabi ng mga tao, wala. And then I go inside the ambulance and I find somebody dying almost in death, we pull him out and we bring them to PGH. There is no need to explain who I am. I know who I am. I do not lie, Mr. President. I am very candid. You know that, Mr. President. I stood up here when Las Cañas came out here, and I said, I am not going to support it because I am not going to tolerate a liar in this Senate. He has lied before and he's going to come here again. Give it to another committee, Mr. President. I will not allow it. But when it comes right here, and I heard the distinguished senator from Batangas, Senator Legarda, saying that she did not know about it, and she even asked if this statement, this resolution, was going to be circulated and signed by everyone. Your resolution, yeah. Yeah, you signed it, but you said to me just a while ago that you were going to ask everybody.
I'll stand because you mentioned me. I will stand.
Good.
Senator Legarda, please respond.
Yes. No, I just, sorry, I had to make an important call, and I apologize to Senator Gordon. My name was mentioned. May I just be clarified in
I
what
mentioned
light?
The name of Senator Legarda because she said she was going, she signed it, but she said she asked the person who was circulating it to make sure that all the others.
Oh, yes. Let me clarify. Yes, it was Senator Pangilinan who came to Senator Binay and then next to me and gave me a folder for a resolution. And Senator Kiko left it on my desk. I think I was doing my paperwork as always. And he said, I'll just come back for it. I said, okay, let me read it. I went through it and I agreed. That's why I affixed my signature. And Nancy was beside me, Senator Binay. I said, Nancy, have you signed? Yes, I signed. And I think he mentioned there are 14 who have signed. I said, don't forget my other seatmate, Senator Villar, and all the others there. And then you proceeded to go around the hall. So I don't know what happened after that, Mr. President. So that's all.
Thank you.
I just clarified the mention of my name. Senator Binay is a witness to that. I said, please let the others sign the resolution as well, because I thought that it was an acceptable resolution, which I wanted to affix my signature to. That's all. Thank you.
The point that I was trying to make was that a request was made by the senator that she will sign in the understanding that the paper was going to be circulated to everyone. And you heard Senator Villar. She was not aware of it. You heard Senator Soto. He was not aware of it. We heard the Senate President himself said he was not aware of it. I don't know if Senator Pacquiao was aware of it. He says he's not aware of it. A lot of us were not made aware of it. And Mr. President, that is perfidiousness. That is a deliberate attempt or an act, a fulfilled act of black propaganda, Mr. President. You know, they will try as much as possible when their arguments cannot make it on the floor, they will go out of the floor and try to get their position outside the floor, Mr. President. I would be beholden to my colleagues if they will stop talking, Mr. President, while we're talking here, with all due respect. And I will stop talking while some people are talking, Mr. President. This is something that we're beginning to lose here in this Senate. We're supposed to listen to one another, and we have done this many times. And I would not want to have the Senate President have to bang the gavel and say, order. And out of respect, I would ask other senators to respect others. And I will continue only when they have stopped, Mr. President. I was told by a very senior personality here that when somebody is speaking, you should keep quiet and nobody should even stand up. And this is precisely the problem. We have forgotten traditions in the Senate. We have forgotten respect, candor. We have forgotten how to say, can you discuss this? Can I discuss this with you? And if you disagree, I will respect you. We can disagree on the floor. But give us a fair chance, Mr. President. We were not given a fair chance. I probably would have signed it. How many times? Even if I knew this propaganda, I probably would have signed it. But the point is, it is a lie to make it appear that we did not sign it. And the blog says so. And other newspaper men have said so. Sinasabi, hindi kayo pumirma. My children, my daughter, who is very sensitive, said so. And I say, I was not asked. I was in Vietnam, Mr. President. You know that. And Mr. President, when you allow this thing to happen, this is when the Senate deteriorates. And when it deteriorates, Mr. President, we start mistrusting one another. We start disrespecting one another. And we start using unparliamentary language. And we start beginning to act as if we are like the Butangeros of Taiwan na nagsusuntukan na doon sa chamber. This is a Senate of respect. We are celebrating our 100 years of Senate history, Mr. President. And it behooves every one of us to respect one another. Friend or foe, on the political spectrum, we must respect one another. And that is what is demanded. That is why we have rules. That is why there is a chairman. And that is why we have a committee on ethics. This is not a ground for investigation of public order, or for that matter, information. This is an ethics case. Because it goes into the morality of whoever did this, Mr. President. If he did so deliberately, it becomes an ethics case. The man who deliberately did this was perpetrating something on his colleagues. What? To gain brownie points? We're used to that. Every day I get hit. We all get hit. This is the era of unaccountability. This is the very essence. Last night I heard the President speak about the youthful offender law, but about his friendship with Sharon Cuneta. But he perorated against the youthful offender law that kids are being utilized to kill. And to a certain extent, Mr. President, I gave it a lot of thought. And Mr. President, I came down to the conclusion that if we keep allowing our children and our people not to be accountable to what they do or what to say, eh talagang, wala na talaga, we have lost our moral compass. Did you not see, did you not hear Popoy? He said, pupunta ako doon, pinapunta ako doon, susunod ako ng blindly. Did you not hear when I said to the dean no less of UST, yan ba ang fraternity nyo? Ikaw ang dean. Pinapayagan mo, magsinungaling yan? Tama ba yan? And it boils down to what? When the fraternity becomes a barkada or when the Senate becomes a barkada, tayo-tayo, sila-sila, pwede na magsinungaling sa isa't isa. Everything is free. The end justifies the means. I would not want to be a Senate like this, Mr. President. Because I think the Senate is a proud institution. We are supposed to be the senior statesman here. I am ashamed. And I am embarrassed. I see some athletes here, some of them disabled. Or rather, you know, with the disabilities. And Mr. President, they try. They try in spite of yung kanilang kapasanan to move ahead in life. They don't lie. They accept the reality that they may not have complete use of their faculties and their bodies, and yet the truth is, they try. They show the truth that even if you are disabled, you can do right. The only disability here that we accept is moral disability. And this is moral disability of the highest order. And whoever perpetrated this, I'm sure has a record of wrong in the past. And he must answer. And that is where the problem is. Kung hindi natin maayos ang Senado, huwag na natin imbestigayin yung mga pulis na sinasabi natin, wala nangyayari sa investigasyon dahil magkabaro sila. Wala mangyayari dyan. Magkabaro yung mga pulis eh. Wala mangyayari dyan. Dahil papayagan na lang makalusot yan. Magkapartido sila. Wala tayong mag-imbestiga. Wala tayong mag-imbestiga. Useless mag-imbestiga. Kasi sabihin natin, magkabaro sila. Ay, kasama natin sa Senado yan. We cannot call him down. Talagang ganyan dito sa Senado. I've heard that before! And I'm saying this at the top of my voice because I've heard it before, because it seems that our ears have become deaf. That we have ourselves lost the ability to discern what must be done. And when we have failed to do that, then we stop respecting one another, Mr. President. I don't have to justify myself on this. I know who I am, and I know many of you are honorable men and women. We call each other, will the honorable gentleman yield? My God, it might be harder for me to do that to some people here now. And I don't want to do that, no matter how ordinary they are, no matter how sometimes obtuse they are. We still have to call them honorable. But the term honorable is earned. It is not a title. Just as leadership is action, it is not position. And just because you got elected to the Senate, doesn't entitle you to privileges. Alam niyo, pagka kayo nasa publiko, babatuhin kayo ng lahat, lalo na kung may ginagawa kayong tama, babatuhin kayo ng tama ng lahat. Sabi nga sa akin ng nanay ko ng araw, mga bato ng bato siya, mga kalaban natin, huwag ka mag-alala, anak. Pagka binato ka, sabi nga ng Biblia, isipin mo lang tinapayan at magtatayo tayo ng panaderia balang araw. And that's exactly what this is. We can forget this blog. I can forget it. I can forgive it. It has no legal significance as far as I'm concerned. It is untruth. It is a lie. But what I cannot forget, and what I challenge, no less than the Senate President, no less than every senator here, is our ability to punish our own when we do wrong. If we cannot do that, then we indeed have lost our moral compass, Mr. President. Thank you and forgive me for my passion and emotion, because this is something unforgivable as far as I'm concerned.
Senator Pangilinan, Aquino.